The Jumper. Once upon a time, in the vast continent of Rolva, there was a huge battle between two kingdoms. One led by King Julian of Meridon, and the other by Queen Minerva of Klong. The battle lasted for days. Seeing her army fail, Queen Minerva cursed the kingdom of Meridon.
King Julian, you've used treacherous ways to win this battle, and so I curse you that when you return home, your subjects will turn into animals. I curse you!
Saying this, Queen Minerva disappeared. King Julian did not pay heed to her curse, and returned to his kingdom where he received a great reception by his daughter. The next day, however, when he was in the courtroom, suddenly, one by one, all his ministers started to turn into animals.
Oh no! Her curse actually worked!
Father, it is not just our ministers, but everyone in the kingdom has turned into animals!
Call for the fairies!
The fairies were summoned, but they couldn't reverse the curse.
Call for the hermit!
And soon the hermit came, but he too failed in reversing the curse.
My king, this curse is irreversible. Only the one who has cast the spell shall be able to reverse it. I am sorry.
The king and the princess were sad. Just then, an idea struck Princess Arya.
Father, remember Hikachu, your wise advisor.
I most certainly do. Oh, he has turned into a dog. Oh, I wish I could have used his help in these moments of crisis.
You still can.
What do you mean?
The curse has turned our subjects into animals, but it has not taken away the power of human reasoning and speech. They can still talk, at least some of them.
The king was delighted to hear that.
Amazing! How did I not know this? Call for Hikachu at once.
Princess Arya called for Hikachu, and he came at once.
Welcome, Hikachu. How have you been?
I have turned into a dog. How do you think I have been?
My bad. Perhaps we should forget about the greetings and come straight to the point.
That would be wonderful.
Tell me, Hikachu, what can bring us out of this curse?
As the hermit said, the curse can only be broken by the one who has cast it.
Looks like there's only one solution. I'm listening.
We will have to make a peace with Queen Minerva.
Well, I am ready. But you know her. She will never agree to the offer of peace.
Then give her what she wants.
At this, King Julian became quiet and sad.
What does she want, Father?
My princess, she wants the Sword of Magic.
The Sword of Magic?
It is our ancestral sword, passed down in our family for generations. Its energies make our army impervious to hunger, the rains, the heat, and even the storms, giving us advantage over the opponent's army. Your grandfather gave it to me, and I had hoped that one day I will pass it on to your husband. Yes, which does now not seem to be possible. Send the fairies to Klong to invite Queen Minerva to our yearly Jumper Festival. Tell her that at the end of the event, I will present to her the Sword of Magic.
The fairies presented Queen Minerva with the king's offer. She smiled.
The day has finally come. I accept the invitation. Tell King Julian that I shall be there to attend the event and take the Sword of Magic.
Soon, it was the day of the yearly Jumper Festival. Everyone was excited. The king and the princess announced the beginning of the event. Queen Minerva was present, too. Now amongst the participants, the frog, the rabbit, and the grasshopper were considered to be the best jumpers that had ever lived in Meridon.
We are about to start, Your Majesty.
Very well.
Good afternoon, y'all. Welcome to the yearly Jumper Festival.
Let the games begin.
Yay! Woohoo!
Woohoo! First up, I present to you the frog.
Greetings, Your Majesty. Princess Aria, Queen Minerva of Klong, and greetings, beings of Meridon. I am the frog from the valleys of the north, and it is a great honor to be a part of the Jumper Festival.
The king was quite impressed by the frog's manners.
He is really well-mannered. I wonder what he looked like as a man. Maybe if all goes well and the curse is removed, we can ask him to marry you.
Here we go again. The frog stepped onto the stage and got into place. The crowd waited, still. He took a deep breath, and just as he was about to take the leap and jump, a fly came hovering near him. He got distracted and started going after the fly.
Boo! I should have let my little one participate. He would have done a much better job.
Well, that was disappointing. But don't worry, because presenting next, the rabbit!
Yay!
Yay! Woohoo!
Greetings, Your Majesty. I am the rabbit from the hills to the west of the Salina River.
The rabbit, too, was poised and well-mannered, which pleased the king.
Not interested.
The rabbit pushed hard and jumped and landed right in front of the king. The king was impressed.
Amazing, rabbit. Well done.
Queen Minerva was also amused by the rabbit's jump. She smiled and clapped her hands.
And finally, I present to you the grasshopper.
Yay!
Yay!
The grasshopper was silent. He did not speak a word, nor did he greet the king.
From the scent that I'm picking up from him, I know that he is from a good family and a very daring being.
Ah, very well then. I shall say no more. Let the trial commence.
The grasshopper got into position, and immediately, and just as he was about to jump, his senses picked up something coming from behind, tearing the air. He immediately understood that it was an arrow that was heading towards Queen Minerva. He immediately jumped up and with a mighty kick changed the course of the arrow. The arrow missed the queen and hit the bark of a tree. Queen Minerva was shocked. So was King Julian. Just then, an eagle carrying a bow and an arrow came out and started screaming at the grasshopper.
You fool! Why did you save the evil queen who has ruined our lives?
She is the royal guest and under the protection of our king while she is here. Your actions have ruined the reputation of our king.
Hearing this, Queen Minerva was very impressed.
Thank you, Grasshopper. And to Queen Minerva, I am very, very sorry. Please forgive the eagle, for his anger got the better of him.
I do not care about the eagle. Its arrow cannot cause me any harm, even if it touched me. You know that? We have fought battles with each other, but I must say I am impressed by the grasshopper.
Saying this, Queen Minerva pointed at the grasshopper, and soon it transformed into a handsome soldier.
It is Ragnar, the mighty soldier.
Princess Aria smiled as she saw Ragnar. She had always liked him, even without his knowledge.
Ragnar, thank you for not worrying about the competition and putting your life at risk in order to protect me and your king's reputation. Ask me for anything.
Thank you, Queen of Klong. I wish all beings of Meridon be freed from their spell and returned to their human form.
The queen was surprised by Ragnar's wish.
Are you sure that is what you want? I can give you all the riches in the world.
I assure you, I do not care for any of those things.
Queen Minerva was very impressed, for she had never seen a soldier so strong and loyal towards his king and his people. She turned to King Julian.
Let us finish this rivalry. First, I would like to propose that I adopt Ragnar as my son and heir to my throne.
Everyone was shocked, including Ragnar.
Ragnar, do you agree?
I have never experienced a mother's love as my mother died when I was born. If your majesty would allow me, then yes, I agree.
I announce Ragnar as the true son and rightful heir of Queen Minerva.
Yay!
Oh, yay!
King Julian raised his hand, and the crowd went silent.
And what is your second proposal?
I propose that my son and your daughter be married.
Well, I don't know if my daughter...
Father, I agree.
Ragnar smiled, for he loved the princess too.
Wow, didn't know it would be that easy. All right, Minerva, you get that too. Are there any other proposals?
Queen Minerva smiled.
That would be all.
Saying this, she moved her hands in the air, and soon magical sparkles touched all the creatures one by one, and they turned back into their human forms.
Wow! Yes! Yes!
Oh, I am back!
Yay!
Meridon erupted with joy. Ragnar and Princess Arya soon got married, and on that very day, Hikachiyo announced the winner of the yearly jumper festival during the feast.
From being a soldier to a grasshopper, and from a grasshopper to the heir of Klong, Ragnar has made the best jumps and is hence announced as the winner!
And thus, the rivalry between the two kingdoms ended forever. And everyone lived happily ever after.